Good morning, students. Now, in this semester, I am handling the Good morning, students. So, in this semester, I'm handling the cryptography and network security. What is the main aim of this cryptography and network security? So, while you have to communicating the data from one system to another system. So, how we can provide the security while you have to communicating the data from the source system to destination system. So here, you know the computer networks. What is the use of computer network subject? Computer network subject to connecting the different computers in different topologies you have to use to connecting all the computers. And using the ISO OSI layers, you have to communicating the data from one system to another system. But whereas here, while you have to communicating this data, so third party, unauthorized users can access the data and stolen the data or can modify the data. So these are the problems while you have to communicating the data. So that problem you can solve by using this subject, that is the cryptography and network security. So mainly, first one, security means to providing the confidentiality for the data. So here, security generally we have to represented. Three types of security generally we have to represent. First one is the information security. So all over the world, whatever the data you have, that data you can provide the security. Authorized information, for that authorized information only you can provide the security. Second one, cyber security. While you have to connecting with the internet, most of the users, one user you have to connect with many users. So while you have to communicating the data from this user to other persons, that time you can provide the security. That means intranet to internet. So for example, your system is within the intranet, that is the LAN. So you have to connect it with the internet. That time you can provide the security. That is simply you can say that cyber security. So here, while you have to communicating the data and transferring the mails, all type of applications comes under this cyber security. While you have to using the credit card systems, debit cards, so ATM machines, whatever you have to use, all that comes under this All all the data comes under this cyber security. And third one is the network security. While you have to communicate in the data from one user to another user, so one-to-one communication or one-to-many communications. So here you can use one minute. So here, whenever you have to communicate in the data from, one system to another system, so first, whatever the information you have to sending one user to another user, that is the sender and receiver. So first one, the sender, whatever the information you have to send to the receiver, that information you have to convert it into unknown format. That is simply you can say that the whatever the human readable format text is simply you call it as plain text. And this plain text you want to convert into the unknown format, that is the ciphertext. That is simply you call it as encryption. The plain text is converted into ciphertext. You simply call it as encryption. Second one, you want to discuss with that whenever you want to discuss with that ciphertext, whatever the plain text you have to convert into ciphertext, that ciphertext you want to convert into plain text, simply you can use decryption. Simply you can call it as decryption. So the plain text you want to convert into ciphertext is called as encryption, and the ciphertext is converted into plain text is called as decryption. So here this is the main concept, motto, how to first whatever the data you want to send one user to another user, the plain text, that is a human readable format, is converted into unknown format. So this is the way you have to provide in the security while you have to communicate in the data. So that is the that is simply you can say that this is a network security. So this entire subject is simply call it as cryptography and cryptography. This is a encryption and decryption process. These all process simply call it as cryptography. So while encrypting and decrypting the decrypting process, you can use a number of algorithms. You can use it. This is the basic concept of cryptography. And in your syllabus, mainly you have to concentrate on search for, in the first unit, cryptography and network security. In the first unit, mainly you have to concentrate on basic principles of network security and what are the goals of security. So while mainly the security goals are, first one is the confidentiality and the integrity and availability. These are the main three goals mainly. You have the other one also. So mainly these three are the main goals. That is, the first one is the confidentiality. So whatever the data you are using, that data you have to, you can provide the confidentiality. So here you can use it, the confidentiality you can provide for the data as well as Similarly, available to the authorized users, that is the second level. And third one is the integrity. So who are the authorized, who are the unauthorized users accessing the data? Similarly, clean the data. So when these are the security goals, mainly we have to use that is the confidentiality, integrity, and availability. These are the security goals mainly you have to use to providing the security. And you can provide the confidentiality for that data, and this data is available to the only authorized users. And while you have to communicating, you can provide the integrity for that data. And what type of attacks in the first unit, only these are the basic principles only you can study it in the first unit. First one is security goals and attacks. Here you can use the two types of attacks you have to use. One is the passive attacks and second one is the active attacks. One is the passive attacks. One is the passive attacks. While you have to communicating the data from one user to another user without any modification, that means the authorized unauthorized users can access the data, but he could not modify that data. That type of attacks are simply call it as passive attacks. For example, you have to listen. One person you have to calling with the other person in older days you have to use the phones. The third party user just listen his voice. That type of attacks are simply call it as passive attacks. But here in nowadays you can say that while you have to communicating the data, that data only he can access, but he could not modify. That type of attacks are simply called as passive attacks. Second one is active attacks. Active attacks means while you have to communicating the data, the unauthorized users, he can access that data and he can modify that data and he have to resend to the receiver. So this type of while you have to communicating the data, that data he can modify. That type of attacks are called active attacks. So here these type of attacks we have to use in cryptography, passive attacks and active attacks. And the next one is the services. What type of services you have to use, and confidentiality, authentication, availability. So what are the goals you have to study? All this comes under these services. Non-repudiation, availability, access control. So these are the services you have to discuss in basic principles of network security or cryptography. And mechanisms. So here also you can use the mechanism. And the peer entity mechanism, origin entity mechanisms, you have to use peer-to-peer mechanism, peer-to-many mechanisms, what type of mechanisms you have to use during network security. These are the concepts you have to study here. And the other concept you have to discuss with that, mathematics of cryptography. Mathematics of cryptography, mainly you have to concentrate on while you have to converting the plain text to ciphertext, ciphertext to plain text, this type of what type of algorithms we have to use, and here you can what type of substitution techniques you have to use. So generally, while you have to converting the data, plain text to ciphertext, mainly two types of methods you have to use. One is the substitution techniques, and second one is the transposition techniques. Substitution techniques means whatever the character, whatever the words you have to send from one user to another user, that words letters you have to replace it with the other letters. That type of method is simply called as substitution technique. With that substitution techniques, you have to see the cipher method. These are the substitution techniques mainly you have to use it in cryptography. But whereas the second one is the transposition method. In the transposition method, you have to use transposition method. Mainly, you have to concentrate on whatever the data you have. That data you have to rearrange. That is simply you can represent as simply you can say that rearrange in format. That is simply you can transposition, transform the data. Simply you can say that transforming. That transposition technique you have to use. So these are the basic methods, whatever the methods you have to use to converting the plain text to ciphertext. The mathematical way, you can say that what type of keys you have to use while you have to converting the data. So here, the plain text, you want to convert it into ciphertext. Here, converting the data. So what is the key length you have to use? For example, 64-bit key, you want to convert 64-bit key bit data you want to convert. You are using that 16-bit key to converting the plain text to ciphertext. So that is the key length. And ciphers, cipher modes. So here you have to use the two types of cipher modes you have to use. One is the block cipher and the second one is the stream cipher. These are the two modes you have to use. These all things you have to discuss in this mathematics of cryptography. So this is regarding to that first unit. In the first unit, mainly we have to concentrate on basic principles of network security. And in these basic principles, what are the basic terms you have to use in network security, and what are the goals, and what are the attacks, what type of attacks you have to use, and services and mechanisms you have to use. These all things you have to discuss in the first unit. And the second unit, mainly you have to concentrate on symmetric encryption. So already you have to discuss whatever the data you have to communicate, that is the plain text. The original information you have to call it as plain text. The plain text you want to convert into ciphertext, you are using the some keys while you have to converting the data. So here, both sides, at the sender side and receiver side, you are using the same key. That type of encryption is called as symmetric encryption. And that means at the sender side and the receiver side, you are using the same key. While, for example, we want to convert the plain text to ciphertext, again ciphertext to plain text. Using the same key only, you can decrypt. That type of encryption is called symmetric encryption. And that means, a key aithe mana use chesi plain text ni ciphertext ki convert chestamo. Ade key use chesi ciphertext ni plain text ki convert cheyadam. That is simply called as symmetric encryption. So, what is the what type of algorithms you have to use in the symmetric encryption, that is the data encryption standard, the DES and the DDES, and AES, advanced encryption standard. Whereas in the data encryption standard, you have to use the key length, that is the 56 bits. DDES 356, that is the 118 key length you have to use. Whereas in AES, you have to use the 256 key length you have to use. So these all things regarding to that symmetric encryption algorithms you have to discuss in the second unit. And the third unit, mainly you have to concentrate on asymmetric encryption. So, in the second unit, we have to use the same type of key you have to use in both sender side and receiver side. But whereas in asymmetric encryption, you have to use the sender side to converting the plain text to ciphertext, you have to use the one key. At the decryption side, you have to use the another key. Encryption process, you have to use the one key, that is the private key. In the decryption process, you can use the one key, that is the public key. Public key, everybody will know. Only public key, everybody will know. So here, you have to converting the plain text to ciphertext, you have to use, by using the private key, you have to convert it plain text to ciphertext. Whereas you are using the public key, you can convert ciphertext to plain text. So this type of encryption is called asymmetric encryption or public key encryption. You can call it as two key encryption. So this is the number of names you have. That is the asymmetric encryption. So here, what type of algorithms? Whereas in asymmetric encryption, you have to use the DES, AES, DDDS. These are the algorithms you have to use. But whereas in asymmetric encryption, you have to use the algorithm that is a RSA algorithm. Mainly RSA algorithm, you have to use it for the asymmetric encryption. So here, that is RC4. That is these are the algorithms mainly you have to use it in the third unit. So what are the algorithms you have to use in asymmetric encryption? Those algorithms you have to discuss in the third unit. And the fourth unit, mainly you have to concentrate on data integrity and the digital signature schemes and the key management. So here, in this unit, mainly we have to concentrate on whatever the message you have to sending. That message you can access it by the only authorized or unauthorized users. That you have to identify only that is a message authentication. Who are the sending by that message and who are receiving that message? That all you have to identify with this message authentication. Only authorized people only you can access the data. And also we can discuss in this unit regarding to the key management. For example, you have to taking the symmetric encryption. At the sender side and the receiver side, you are using the same key. Same key you have to use the first time, you have to sending the both users. Both users and they can, by using that key, they can encrypt and as well as decrypt. So here, some of the users you can send the key also. So whenever you have to sending the data, with that data you can sending the key, easily another users easily capture that key and data, easily you can decrypt it. So to overcome that problem, here you can use the key distribution center. Key distribution center mainly, that distribution center will generate the keys, and that distribution center will be sent to the both sender and receiver. So that is the main mode of that is the key management. So these are the concepts you have to study in the fourth unit. And the fifth unit and the sixth unit mainly you have to concentrate on what type of layers you have generally. We have the 7 layers, ISOSA layers, generally you have to use. So we have the 7 layers, so that is the physical data link, network, transport, session, presentation, and application layers. So here, mainly you have to use this security, while you have to communicating the data, mainly in 3 layers you can provide the security. First one is the topmost layer is the application layer. In the application layer, you can provide the security by using these methods, that is the PGP, pretty good privacy. With this method, you can provide the security and security mail, internet mail extension. SBI MIME. So by using these security approaches, you can provide the security in application layer. And whereas you have to coming to the how you can provide the security in transport layer, you have to use the two methods we have to use. One is the SSL and the second one is the TLS.
Hello, sir. Sir, why is this limited layer, sir?
Secure socket layer. Now we can add you now. Hello. Hello.
Sir, why is this limited layer, sir?
Now it is clear. So in next class I will check it out. See here. So next one is the transport layer.
సార్ మీ వీడియో కూడా కనిపిస్తుంది, ఆడియో అసలు వినిపించట్లేదు.
ఆడియో అసలు వినిపించట్లేదు.
నౌ ఇట్ ఇస్ క్లియర్. హలో, now it is clear.
ఇప్పుడు క్లియర్ గా ఉంది.
ఇప్పుడు క్లియర్ గా ఉంది అన్నా. ఓకే.
ఆ yes sir.
ఓకే. I will check it out. So here you can use the transport layer. In transport layer, mainly you have to use the two security methods you have to use. One is the SSL and second one is the TLS. First one is the secure socket layer. So by using this method, you can provide the security while you are using the credit card systems, debit card systems. So in all these cases, mainly you have to use these security methods. That is the secure socket layer and transport layer security. So while you have to communicate in the data, how you can communicate? You are using by using the ISO/OSI layers only. You have to communicate the data from one system to another system. So mainly in topmost layers application layer and transport layer and network layer. In these cases, mainly you have to use the secure socket layer, transport layer. Mainly you can provide the security SSL and TLS. And next one, in the sixth unit, mainly you have to concentrate on network layer. How you can provide the security in network layer by using the IP security. That is, generally you have to use the CAPROS. You have to use it to provide the security. And the last concept you have to discuss with that is system security. So you have to giving the passwords to your system. That is simply you can say that how that is the way you can provide the security for your system. That is the system security. These are the concepts you have to discuss in your subject. So first one, you all six in it, mainly we have to concentrate on how we can provide the security while you have to communicate with the data. All these six units mainly have to concentrate on this subject. So after learning this subject, what you have to understand? So mainly you have to understand after studying this subject, security awareness while we have to communicate the data and what is the importance of security. So while we have to communicate the data, for example, you want to send the mail to your friend. So you want to give the money, please send money $1,000 to someone. But that information captured by the authorized user and that may be a kind of corrected to $10,000 and sent to, you are giving the some name, but sent to his name, you have to place it here. Automatically the problem will be like this. This type of problems while you have to facing without using the security. So whenever you have to providing the security, automatically automatically can provide the confidentiality for your data. That is regarding to this clear understanding about this security and its importance. And what are the fundamentals of cryptography? Like symmetric and asymmetric, that is the secret and public key cryptography. And what are the protocols you have to give us? What are the services? Confidentiality, non-repudiation, availability, access control, integrity. So what are the security services we have? What are the protocols you have to use? And what type of threats you have to get in? And how to, whenever the attack is, attack threats is occurred, how to solve that attacks, that is the countermeasures. And security solutions, secure solutions like PGP, SSL, IPsec. So transport layer wise, you can discuss with that one. We have any doubts regarding to this subject? One by one, I have to ask. So up to now, the voice is very slow. Next class onwards, we will check it out. We will sort out. Okay. Any suggestions from you?